Hi friends, I'm Nitin Bord. Today we are discussing about the synthetic utility of active methylene compound by taking the example of acetoacetic ester, especially ethyl acetoacetate. And the structure of ethyl acetoacetate is CH2 C double bond OET. If it is ethyl group, it is ethyl acetoacetate, and if it is methyl group, it is methyl acetoacetate. Both belongs to acetoacetic ester group category, and it belongs to the active methylene because this CH2 group is active because it is lying between two electron withdrawing groups. Such groups which are flanked between electron withdrawing. So what will happen is, if a proton is abstracted from this position, the negative charge generated will be stabilized by this electron withdrawing groups. So the compared to other carbon hydrogen attached hydrogens, or compared to other hydrogens attached to carbon, this carbon hydrogen, hydrogen can be abstracted by very strong base, thereby generate a negative charge that will be stabilized. So this is actually ethyl acetoacetate, and it can be used for so many synthetic applications and the synthetic products related to, or starting from ethyl acetoacetate or acetoacetic ester, and that procedure is called acetoacetic ester synthesis or ethyl acetoacetate synthesis. And the term implies the synthesis from ethyl acetoacetate or acetoacetic ester, not the synthesis of ethyl acetoacetate or acetoacetic ester. Ethyl acetoacetate is synthesized from ethyl acetate. And the synthesis from ethyl acetoacetate, that is called ethyl acetoacetate synthesis. Ethyl acetoacetate synthesis result in the formation of numerous number of compounds with different functional groups. So same functional group may multiply in different number of carboxylic acids and ketones in same material can be generated, so that can be used for the preparation of addition and condensation polymerization products and other useful products. So acetoacetic ester synthesis or active methylene synthesis from active methylene compounds are very important, and some of the strategies adopted for the preparation are: first one, if you are treating with sodium ethoxide, it is a very strong base. So if you are treating with a very strong base, what change will happen in ethyl acetoacetate? It is actually active position. So one proton is abstracted by this base from this position, so it will become negative and Na plus. That means a sodium salt is generated in this step. And another step is treated with alkyl halide or alkyl iodide. If you are treating with alkyl iodide, so first of all we are treating with sodium ethoxide, generating sodium salt, and after that if you are treating with alkyl iodide, so what will happen? You are treating with alkyl iodide, so here it will be eliminated. Sodium halide will be eliminated, and a link between alkyl group and carbon will be generated. So you can generate, or you can introduce an alkyl group at this active position, or carbon-carbon link can be generated in this step. Then another one is, instead of alkyl iodide, if you are using diiodide or dihalide, so the CH2 group, number of CH2 can be increased, or 1, 2, 3, we can increase that one. So depending upon that one, what will happen? We can check. Here, suppose we are treating with diiodomethane, CH2I2. So what will happen? So first we are treating with the sodium ethoxide to make the sodium salt. From after that one, if you are treating with, so first plus 3 followed by methyl iodide. So it will be like this, CH3. You can have another molecule here, CH2. If you are treating in the first step, sodium salt will be generated. So it becomes sodium salt. Here also it becomes sodium salt. Then after that, diiodomethane. So it is actually diiodomethane, CH2, I and iodine. So if you are treating this one, sodium salt will be liberated here. So it will result in the formation of a link between, or that methyl group, newly introduced group, will act as a link between these two acetoacetic esters. So we can introduce a link there. And if you are increasing the number of alkyl groups to 2, 3, 4, n number, we can introduce n number of carbons at this position. So it will be CH2 n times. Instead of this one, if you are taking it, CH2, I. So link with 2 carbons will come. If you are increasing the number to 3 carbon link will come. Similarly, n number of carbon link you can introduce here. Then another step is, so it is introduced there. Then now you can take another acetic ester. Now we can have alcoholic potassium hydroxide followed by hydrolysis. What will happen? So it is actually heating with alcoholic potassium hydroxide, heating with alcoholic potassium hydroxide plus hydrolysis. So whatever be some potassium salt may be generated there, that will be hydrolyzed back to carboxylic acid. So if you are treating the alcoholic potassium hydroxide, the bond cleavage will happen at these two positions. So it will result in the formation of O potassium salt, then CH3 C double bond O potassium salt plus ethanol. So this potassium salt can be regenerated to acid by treated with acid. So this is another method to cleave at particular positions. So if we want to cleave at these two positions, first of all we will introduce some groups here, then only it will be synthetically applicable. So we can introduce something here, then we can cleave here. That means some attached group will be here in this carboxylic acid. So if you are treating the alcoholic potassium hydroxide, we can cleave that one. Then another one, instead of alcoholic potassium hydroxide, if you are using hydrolysis, if you are simply hydrolyze that one, so the ester will be hydrolyzed. Ester will be hydrolyzed to carboxylic acid. It will happen only at this position. Then fifth one, followed by, if hydrolysis with the acid followed by heating, then what will happen? Hydrolysis happened here, so carboxylic acid is generated. Further heating. So we can do this step only, or this step followed by heating. Both will give different products. So hydrolysis followed by heating, what will happen? As it is a beta keto carboxylic acid, decarboxylation will happen. Decarboxylation will happen on heating up before we will do hydrolysis followed by heating. So decarboxylation will result in the formation of a ketone. So we will get a ketone there. Then another one, if we are treating with acid chloride, if you are treating with the acid chloride, you can't directly treat that with the acid chloride. Before that, you should make it sodium salt. So, first step followed by seventh. Usually it will happen like this. First step followed by seventh. Here also, first step followed by third. First step followed by second. These are the procedures. Directly you can't treat with alkyl hydride or dihydro alkane. Direct treatment is difficult. So first sodium salt will be generated followed by second step or reagent in this second position. Then so next one, sodium salt formation followed by treatment with acid chloride. What will happen? So sodium salt is here, sodium salt is generated here, so it will become Na plus minus, sodium salt is generated. Then now you are treating with acid chloride or pH or R acid chloride. So what will happen? This will be eliminated. So here this is actually alpha position, so beta position, this is also beta position, so beta diketone can be produced, and this step can be followed by any of these process. You can do hydrolysis, mild hydrolysis, hydrolysis followed by heating, or alcoholic potassium hydroxide treatment, all can be followed. Correspondingly we can play at any position. Then another process, eighth one, suppose you are treating with aldehyde plus pyridine. So pyridine is a mild but bulky base, so pyridine or diethyl amine, such bases, so ethyl acetate on treatment with aldehyde in presence of mild base, what will happen? So this is actually ethyl acetate. You can have this aldehyde here. If you are treating with in presence of mild base, if you are heating in presence of mild base, one water molecule will be eliminated there, resulting in the formation of a double bond here. So a double bond is formed here. We can introduce a double bond at this position. Then these are some of the interesting steps, and combinations of these steps are important in synthetic procedures. For example, we can consider some of the combinations. We can check some of the combinations in ethyl acetate. Then only we will understand the utility of different combinations. This is ethyl acetate. Ethyl acetate. And in ethyl acetate, we can use some of these combinations. For example, I am using the combination 1 plus 7 plus 6. This is one combination I am trying. So what will happen? First step is formation of sodium salt. So first of all, sodium salt will be formed here. Then second one, we are adopting is seventh one, treatment with acid chloride. So if you are treating with acid chloride, what will happen? So Na, then Cl, acid chloride, RCOCl. So what will happen? It will be eliminated. So it will result in the formation of a compound like this. Then another one is not completed. The sixth step also we should do. So hydrolysis followed by heating. So hydrolysis followed by heating means here hydrolysis at position will happen. So it will become carboxylic acid. So if you are taking instead of sixth, if you are taking fifth, that will be the product. Instead of fifth, we are having the combination. If fifth is the combination here, 1, 7, 5, the product will be like this. Instead of 5, if you are taking 6, that means one heating process is also there. So what will happen in that heating process? Decarboxylation will happen. So the decarboxylation step is also there. So it will be a diketone. So we can form a diketone, and the R group introduced is our choice with a diketone formation. Then this is actually a combination of these steps. Then we can consider another combination. For example, another combination, I am trying this one. 1, 3, plus either 4 or 6. So now we are taking 4, step 4. These are the combination I am adopting. And the case 3, I am using methyl, diiodomethyl. This is starting diiodomethyl. Suppose this is starting material I am taking, diiodomethyl. What will be the product? First of all, in first step, sodium salt will be formed there. So sodium salt, then sodium salt of another ethyl acetate. Then next one, treated with the CH2I2. This is actually the second step. It is eliminated. So a link is formed between these two ethyl acetoacetates. A link is formed between that two. Then, so the first step is over, third step is over. And I mean, third step means the third we classified something, that is over. Then fourth one. What is actually the fourth one to be adopted? It is heating with alcoholic potassium hydroxide followed by hydrolysis. Alcoholic potassium hydroxide, if you are heating, hydrolysis happen at this position. Hydrolysis will happen at this position. So result will be potassium salt of acid here, that can be on treatment with acid. First of all, potassium salt will form on treatment with acid medium. Carboxylic acid will be regenerated. Regenerated carboxylic acid. So it is a dicarboxylic acid. So dicarboxylic acid with five carbon. So it is glutaric acid. Then, so preparation of glutaric acid. What is actually the advantage of this dicarboxylic acid? With the help of this dicarboxylic acid, we can do condensation polymates, or we can prepare condensation polymates. For example, instead of in the second step, if you are taking, I mean in this step, if you are taking CH2 CH2II. What will happen? It is similar to introduction of one more carbon here. So now it is just changing one material, one reagent in any of these steps will result in another product. What is this? It is actually adipic acid. Adipic acid. So, what is actually the use of adipic acid? Hexamethylene tetramine and adipic acid. We will get a nylon 6,6. We can generate polymers. These are also used for condensation polymers. So, these three combinations will give a dicarboxylic acid and the number of intervening carbons that we can choose in this process. Then, now we can check another combination. We can do another combination. So, it will be step 8 plus either step 4 or step 6. We can take 4. Step 8 plus step 4. If you are taking these two combinations, 8 and treated with aldehyde followed by alcoholic potassium hydroxide. So, this is actually our active methylene compound, CH3, C double bond O, CH2, C double bond O, OET. If you are treating with aldehyde, this is actually aldehyde, so it is, we can take it as R, aldehyde. So what will happen? Treatment of aldehyde in pyridine base. So one water molecule is eliminated here, that means a double bond is created here. A double bond is created at that position. Now we can do the next step. Treatment with alcohol. So this one is over. Next one, treatment with alcoholic potassium hydroxide. So alcoholic potassium hydroxide followed by hydrolysis will give a product like this. It is cleaved at this position. Here, potassium salt will generate followed by hydrolysis regenerate the acid. So, this is actually alpha beta unsaturated carboxylic acid. Alpha beta unsaturated carboxylic acids are very good starting materials in addition polymerization. It is similar to the structure of Cl, or we can have cyano, or we can have carboxylic acid, discarboxylic acid. So we can have polymerization possibility n times. So we will get addition polymerization from this starting material. So these are also can be used for preparation of useful polymers. So we can have different combinations from this depending upon our starting material and depending upon our requirement of product or our synthetic requirement. We can adopt different synthetic strategies, different combinations in this, and we can prepare different products. For example, if you are asked to prepare adipic acid, we can take different combinations. We know the combination, what are the requirements. If we ask to prepare a beta diketone or beta alpha beta unsaturated carboxylic acid, these are all possible by this synthetic strategy. So acetoacetic ester and different acetoacetic esters like ethyl acetate or methyl acetoacetate, they are very useful synthetic starting materials for the preparation of useful products. And as a homework, you can do different combinations of this and can prepare different useful products starting from ethyl acetoacetate. Okay.